गुड आफ्टरनून आरुषि, बेस्ट ऑफ लक एंड थैंक यू सर फॉर कोऑर्डिनेटिंग द इवेंट.
थैंक यू मैम.
रिकॉर्डिंग ले कर लेना बच्चे और स्क्रीनशॉट जरूर ले लेना, मुझे चाहिए होंगे, प्रिंट आउट्स निकालने होते हैं.
ओके
एक दो मिनट वेट कर लो, अगर कोई आता है तो ठीक है, नहीं तो इवेंट स्टार्ट कर दो.
मैम स्टार्ट करूं?
प्लीज स्टार्ट कर दो बेटे.
गुड आफ्टरनून रिस्पेक्टेड डायरेक्टर सर, एचओडी मैम, माय टीचर्स, माय सीनियर्स एंड माय बैचमेट्स. मायसेल्फ आरुषि कटवाल फ्रॉम सी डिपार्टमेंट फर्स्ट ईयर एंड आई एम हियर टू कंडक्ट एन इवेंट ऑन डीबीएमएस और डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम. नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट द इवेंट. What is database management system? A database management system or DBMS or simply a database system consists of a collection of interrelated and persistent data usually referred to as the database. A set of application programs used to access, update and manage that data which form the data management system. Brief history. Early 1960s, first general purpose database by Charles Beckman from GE used the network data model. Late 1960s, IBM developed information management system used the hierarchical data model, led to SABRE, the airline reservation system developed by AA and IBM, still in use today. 1970s, Eager Code of IBM developed the relational data model, led to several DBMS based on relational model as well as important theoretical results. Coates win Turing Award. 1980s, relational model dominant SQL standard. Late 1980s, 1990s, DBMS vendors extend system align more complex data types, image, text. Why use a DBMS? Data independent. Purpose of DBMS. Data redundancy and consistency. Same information may be duplicated in several places. All copies may not be updated properly. Difficulty in new program to carry out each new task. Data isolation. Data in different formats. Difficult to write new application programs, files, and formats. Security problem. Every user of the system should be able to access only the data they are permitted to see. Example, payroll people only handle employee records and can't see customer accounts, and tailors only access account data and can't see payroll data. Integrity problems. Data may be required to satisfy constraints. Example, no account balance below $25. Again, difficult to enforce or to change constraints from the with the file processing approach. Types of data models. First is hierarchical model. Second is network model. Third is relational model. Fourth is object-oriented model. Fifth is semi-structured model. Hierarchical model. The hierarchical data model organizes data in a tree structure. There is a hierarchy of parent and child data segments. Their structure implies that a record can have repeating information generally in the child data segments. Hierarchical DBMS were popular from the late 1960s with the introduction of IBMS, Information Management System, DBMS, through the 1970s. Network model. The popularity of the network data model coincided with the popularity of the hierarchical data model. Some data were more naturally modeled with more than one parent per child. So the network model permitted the modeling of many-to-many relationships in data. 1971, the Conference on Data System Language, CODASYL, formally defined the network model. Relational model. RDBMS or Relational Database Management System. A database based on the relational model developed by EF Code. A relational database allows the definition of data structures, storage and retrieval operations and integrity constraints. In such a database, the data and relations between them are organized in tables. A table is a collection of records, and each record in a table contains the same fields. Object-oriented model. Object DBMS add database functionality to object programming language. They bring much more than persistent storage of programming language objects. A major benefit of this approach is the unification of the application and database development into a seamless data model and language environment. Semi-structured model. In semi-structured data model, the information that is normally associated with a schema is contained within the data, which is sometimes called self-describing. In such a database, there is no clear separation between the data and the schema, and the degree to which it is structured depends on the application. Components of DBMS. Hardware can range from a PC to a network of computers. Software, DBMS, operating system, network software, if necessary, and also the application programs. Data. Used by the organization and a description of this data called the schema. People includes database designers, DBAs, application programmers, and end users. Procedure instructions rules that should be applied to the design and use of the database and DBMS. Advantages of DBMS: controlling redundancy, sharing of data, data consistency, integration of data, integration constraints, data security, report writers, control over concurrency, backup and recovery procedure, data independence. Last is data in disadvantage of DBMS: cost of hardware and software, cost of data conversion, cost of staff training, appointing technical staff, database damage. Thank you.
Thank you, Arushi. It was awesome presentation. Keep it up. And I feel kal Praful ka hai, wo bhi bahut acha karne wala hai. Thank you, Gaurav sir and Shilpi ma'am, ki aapne event join kiya. Best of journey, Arushi. And thank you all participants or all attendees. Me,
thank you, ma'am.
Sharma, Neeraj Srivastav, Jeevika, Himanshi, and Gaurav Singh, Arushi Katiyar. Chalo, thank you, bachcho.